We want to identify crime and prosecute it. And we're specially trained to do that. I truly believe we're the best at what we do. But it is crucial that we have the public behind us to be our eyes and notify us when they see an environmental crime, no matter how small.
It's pretty much just a third world garage, but he's grabbing all of his solvents and dumping them either down the drain on the edge of the street.
Jonathan is stationed here in Travis County right with primary duties to Travis and all the surrounding counties in Central Texas. He works closely with his counterpart investigator with the TCEQ as well as special agents with the US EPA.
Sometimes he puts it in the street.
He's been involved in cases that have resulted in extremely large fines.
I took the sample.
And those fines came about because of his hard work and attention to detail.
I never know what Jonathan is going to bring through the door. It could be water samples, it could be soil samples, different hazardous wastes.
Hey, Pamela. Got some more goodies for you.
Hi, John. What do you have?
Well, I got four.
He risks exposure every time he goes out into the field and is willing to bring these hazardous things in for testing and analysis so that he can make guilty people stop dumping and stop polluting.
In this day and age, the law requires that you have analytical sampling to determine what the constituent is or what the pollutant is. That is part of the element of the crime. So our lab is absolutely the most important element in making our case.
Used motor oil, lubricating oil, non-toxic antifreeze,
yes.
There's some PAHs.
As investigators, sometimes we don't have the time to sit out in front of a gate or surveil an operation or interview 20 people to figure out what's going on. It's a lot easier to make a call over here and get put on the flight schedule to do an overflight.
Because airspace is free, we can get a view that you're not always going to be allowed to get down on the ground. Jonathan Gray has a nose for these illegal activities, and he's very productive.
Jonathan is a passionate supporter of the fish and wildlife resources in the state of Texas, and he takes it personally when people want to dump hazardous waste on anybody's habitat.